Let's see if maybe we can go sideways off here, right onto the road! Oh, shit! Don't bring me back. Everybody, it's your boy the Slab Train, and welcome back, guys, to some more Grand Theft Auto 5 online gameplay. Someone's got a horn in the background going off, but today we're gonna be having a look at another car build today, and I'm not even gonna try and pronounce this damn car. This is the FGT, and it looks stunning. 4-liter engine, 280 horsepower, the top speed of 155 miles an hour, 0 to 60 in 5 damn seconds. Now, this thing very much looks like an FRS, a BRZ, however you want to take it, it looks very similar. Now, I'd like to know your thoughts in the comment section below. What does this car look like to you? It looks very well. I mean, the front end looks like an FRS, almost with a BMW style back. I don't know, man. Grand Theft Auto does a great job mixing in cars to one car. It's just absolutely ridiculous. I want this thing in red. It looks hella dope. And I'm gonna order this bitch right now, man. It's a lot of damn money, unfortunately, but I'm down to give it a shot. Now, one car that I do have to get rid of, unfortunately, is going to be the Batty 801. I don't really care about the bike, man. I'm not a fan of that Batty, but I am a fan of this FGT, and that's what we're gonna be doing. And oh my god, I'll see you guys back in the showroom when we got it. All right, guys, we are here in the damn showroom. Let's see if our GT is waiting for us right now. I hope it is, so I want to drive it right now, man. I really do. Now, we are staying in first person mode for the time being. It's not here yet, man. Where is it? It's coming. It's coming soon. Where you at? Where you at? Which space do you think it's going to pop into? Oh, no, it's going to be right here, man, because of the baddie. Okay. We'll wait. Oh, there it is. What the hell's with this orange? I didn't order orange. Come on now. Thing does look beast. Look at how damn big these rims are in the back. These are like 20s guaranteed. Holy shit. All right. Dual exhaust on the back, quad tips. Okay. Lampo daddy. Okay, so it's like a damn Lamborghini almost. I mean, that's always cool. That shifter though. Look at that shifter. Oh my god. Let's get a little bit lower in here to have a quick look. I gotta say, this interior is beautiful with this red pinstriping in this. I want to get another look in this interior, man. Look at that gear shifter, though. That is absolutely vicious. Four seats, unfortunately, cannot utilize those two. I wish that we could, man. If we had a four-seater, you know, why not have them able to get into the back seats? I mean, you could do it in real life. Why not Grand Theft Auto, man? That's some bogus. All right, so we do have this Drift King waiting outside right now. I don't even know who this man is, but I'm willing to pick up a stranger right now. There he is. Come on in, my man. Where you at? Is he back in his car? I think he is. So we're going to head over to Los Santos Customs right now. Hopefully not damaging this thing at all. Excuse me. Whew. This thing is quick, though. Not as fast. And really, I mean, as I said, it's only a damn, I think it was like 150 horsepower. It's not a lot, or it was like 250 or something like that. So it's really not that, you know, say powerful of a car, but it does look like it handles very nicely. Holy shit. Banging redline at 9,000 RPM. I'm already a big fan of this car. Redline bang, count me in, man. We're gonna be able to see what we can do with this thing. I gotta say, this red and orange, I am not a fan of at all. We have to get this thing either one color. But look at that, though. God damn, that's beautiful. Alrighty, that is a damn crazy word, though. If you guys want to go ahead and take your take on that in the comment section below, try to give that a pronunciation. Spell it out in the comments. See what you can do, but that is a damn tough word. We're not even doing any of those horns. We will throw on the xenon headlights. I'm not feeling a neon kit at the moment, and I'm really hoping that we are able to do something with the bumpers on this car. Otherwise, I'm gonna be pretty damn upset, man. We spent almost $500,000 on this thing. Now that's gonna be, I want to be able to customize some damn front bumpers and such, you know. I got a turbo. That's good. Wheels. This is not looking good right now. I want some damn customization right now. I really do. I hope it's here, man. I really do. Rims, though. I don't know what the hell I want for rims. Now, these are some beefy damn tires and rim combination. So, I would like to have something that would fill in these gaps. Those do look dope. We're going to go with the Cheetah RRs on this thing here. And it really does look hella damn nice, man. They're pretty vicious on here. Nice thin wheel, but I'm thinking of painting these white just to have these pop a little bit more. Now, obviously, these are some beefy damn rims. So, they're going to look a little bit weird from, you know, close up. But I think at a far, though. And look at that. We have no way to change any of the bumpers or anything like that. I am pretty damn disappointed in this car. And I mean, I feel that in this game, you know, if you're spending $500,000 on something, they should at least give you the opportunity to change up some of the damn body panels, or at least have them in the game. You know what I'm saying? So I know they do it for some cars, they don't do it for others. I don't know. I just really was hoping for something on this car, especially because I really do enjoy the look of this thing, and I really wanted to, you know, add maybe a splitter or something like that, just to kind of put it off that much more. Now, I'm thinking of maybe doing a nice matte paint job on this thing. We could do that. Do a nice matte black. And you know what? I think this is going to look dope with a nice matte black on here. Let's get that secondary color. Just completely black it out, maybe? Oh, I don't know, man. We could do it. But I don't think I'm feeling it, though. I'm not even feeling this primer. And look at the damn... like, I'm not even feeling the whole color scheme on this damn car with the two-tone. Like, that is the worst two-tone job I've ever seen. It doesn't even follow the hood whatsoever. It just kind of does its own thing. So, God, man, they really fumbled the ball on this car, guaranteed. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. What do you think of this thing, man? I'm not happy with it already, I can tell you that. We're going to go with the carbon black, and then we're also going to just go with the carbon black as well, too, on the top, maybe. Or even we can go with the salmon pink. I'm just kidding. We're not doing that. What about the white? We can maybe do a white on this, or a silver some sort. Let's do that. So let's go with black steel, and then what we're going to do is we're going to also make the rims that same black steel color. I think that's going to make it look a little bit better, and just kind of make that damn two-tone pop a little bit more. What else do we have? We have a bronze. Ooh. Ooh. I like that, actually. Let's go with that bronze. Okay. So that is going to be it for our damn FGT right here. I don't know, man. Let me know your thoughts on this thing. God. I feel that it could have used a lot more. I don't know, man. Definitely shreds damn rubber, though. So it sounds like a damn turbine taking off. We're going to be going through the city with this thing, having some fun with it, doing a little review, and seeing if this thing is really worth $500,000, man, because there are a lot of cars out there that you can pick up for $500,000 that, you know, will be probably that much better than this thing. I mean, even Drift King's got a damn dope four-door right there. Oh my God, let's follow this man. Whew, does slide nice though. Now again, this is stage 3 engine, not stage 4. Ooh, that acceleration though off the line. I'm looking first person. Ooh. Handling seems to be pretty damn nice on this. We did not touch the brakes whatsoever. These brakes are stock. Oh, shit. We're alright, though. We're alright. See if he does the same thing. Oh, look at him. He's all the way. Oh, damn. Eyes on the road, man. Eyes on the damn road. Alright, I do see a really nice S-corner section on our left-hand side. So we're going to take it up this hill and then bring it through these downhill sections to really get a feel of how this car is going to perform on some treacherous terrain. Here we go. We're on sidewalk. Never mind. I don't know why it's on the damn sidewalk. Ooh! No, not yet. Ripped that e-brake a little bit too early. Now, one thing that I do want to start doing as well, too, is once I get involved in the story missions a little bit more on Grand Theft Auto 5 online, or on single player, I'm going to start doing these builds offline with the Slidey Cars cheat, like I was doing before on the 360. And I tried doing it right before this video, but unfortunately, because of the fact that I'm not too far into the campaign, we just two-wheeled, that I wasn't able to, you know, do the builds the way that I wanted. Didn't have the money or cars. What the hell did we just hit right there? What the hell was that? Oh man, poor thing. Let's have a quick look at this engine bay. Let's see if this thing is worth the $500,000 underneath the hood of this damn car. Why are we in passive mode? That's what I would like to know. Disable passive mode, thank you. 8 seconds we got, that's all right. You guys like my t-shirt, by the way? I just got it. Looks beautiful. Look at it, man. You're jealous. You're jealous. It's okay. All right. See if we can pop this thing. Oh, one shot on that. What do we got underneath the hood of this thing? See ya. Ooh, damn. Let's have a quick look at this thing zoomed in right now. I will say this looks absolutely stunning. Okay, okay. The turbo's in there somewhere, man. I see it. Alright, so we're saying that we have no damn hood, and I'm feeling this big jump right here. What the hell is this? I don't know what it is, but let's get a feeling of this car in the air, man. I'm gonna just hit that very hard. And I gotta say, overall, this car has been nice to drive, but like I said, there's no customization factor for me, and that is the problem. You know, a car can be great, can be fast, but if you have no customization, you can't make it your own! Oh my god, I just hit the damn chimney. Come on now. But we are on the rooftop, though. Ooh. What do you guys know about this rooftop life? Where can we go from here, anyways? Oh my god. Look at us now, man. Oh, man. We're a little bit on the damn crazy side right now. See where this goes over here. Woo! Now, I'm curious if I can jump over to that other side. I don't think so now just because I went off of this. But I think if I was not on that, I could have maybe jumped it. Let's see if maybe we can go sideways off here right onto the road. Oh, shit. Oh, yo, how did this guy come right there? My bad, my bad. That's my fault right there. Alright, we are going to go into first person for a little bit here. Take us on a drive down into the city and see how it handles in some very tight traffic. I mean, like I said, though, even coming through these sections here, I mean, car feels really nice. I would have loved to got this on the Slidey Cars cheat, and I may have to revisit this car. Oh my god! Two-wheeled right there. Sorry, man. I didn't mean to damn scratch your car there. Now, holding A does make us kneel down or duck down, but it is very tough to see anything when you're like this, so we're gonna just gonna not do that. We're actually gonna follow this man's waypoint as well, too. I see that on there. Excuse me. I don't know where he wants us to go. 0.31 miles. He must have his damn car back there. Oh, we almost got T-boned. Now, before we do that, we're going to get a little top speed run right now. We hit 120. And I think we are topped out right now. Is it only 120? Like, what's with all these cars topping out at 120? Ooh. The car is very stable, though, when it comes down on the ground. I mean, usually, when cars hit the ground pretty hard, it's very unstable. But I mean, you know, again, $500,000, we better have a damn solid suspension on this thing. So, final verdict on this thing. I gotta say, I mean, yeah, it's nice and all, but I feel like I just wasted $500,000 on this car. It's something that I'm probably only gonna bring out, you know, maybe a couple more times. Yes, it's nice. Again, there's just no customization factor on it. I love the body lines on this car, so I gotta say, you know, I would have to say, is the car worth a half a mil? No. I would say it would have been a reasonable $200,000 to $300,000 price tag on here, but you know, after it's all said and done, we invested almost, you know, $600,000 into this car for something that we can only really change paint jobs on. So it's a little frustrating. And again, I mean, I'd like to know your thoughts in the comment section below, but I'm really interested in seeing how this is going to do in the single player with the slotty cars cheat, and look for that video very soon. If you guys want to see that, do not forget to slap that damn like button as always. If you guys did enjoy this episode with the FGT, please guys hit that damn subscribe button if you're new. You guys can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, all of which can be found in the description box below. And if you guys want to see some more Grand Theft Auto 5 content daily, please show your support in the comment section below. Ladies and gentlemen, Jabuta Slap Train. I'm out. Peace. Don't bring me back.